Hey, folks, once again, it's Winston Chaney from The Morning Show and also Praise 104.1. Have the pleasure right now, once again, twice in 1 week, talk to my buddy, Jonathan Nelson.
Hey, sir. Doing, I'm doing well. How about you?
I'm doing well, man. That's twice good. In 1 week.
How twice in 1 week. That's all right, ain't it?
That's fine. Listen, how does it feel when you get on stage? Do you transform or just, are you a laid-back guy?
Mm-mm.
But when you get on stage?
For me, I mean, I'm just an energetic person in general, so you get what you like. I am who I am, you know what I mean? And maybe I might give you just a tad bit more, but I give you energy. I try to, for me, like, I get intoxicated as it relates to like connecting with the audience. It's nothing like seeing that one person smile, seeing that one person cry, seeing that one person lift their hands, and so it makes me want to connect and talk to them and communicate with them more. But when I walk on, I already have a focus and I'm ready to go.
Ready to go,
yes, sir.
Which of your songs surprised you the most with the audience as being the biggest, one of the biggest hits?
Tonight or it just in general?
In general.
Healed.
Healed?
Yes. Of course, Donald Lawrence recorded it. I never thought that the song, when I was talking about it tonight, I wrote the song. Arundel Mills was just opening up and everybody was going to be nosy and mm-hmm. to see what was it all about. I was unemployed and I was just kind of window shopping, just walking around, and I literally just started singing the lyrics to myself. I'm healed. Got a story to tell you about some things that I've been through. I didn't think that I didn't have any expectations, if you would, for that song. I was just kind of like writing from my heart and my spirit. And to see all of these years later, you know, over 15 years later, that people, choirs still sing it. You know, you hear it for Offering. I mean, it's a standard. Mm-hmm. And I'm appreciative to Donald for, you know, taking it and really blessing the world with the song. You know what I mean? So, but that is probably the one that has just surprised me the most.
Where did the term strong finish come from?
Well, it's flipped. It is really finished strong. The name of the song is called Finish Strong. But as I was writing it, I was trying to put people in a picture mode of them being on life's track. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like a racetrack, if you would. That's kind of how I saw it. And so the lyric says, in this race that we run, you have to have endurance because it's a marathon. So as we were getting to the hook of the song, I wanted to feel like people were almost like racing. So strong finish, you know what I mean?
Okay,
so it didn't fit that way. Okay, so I kind of flipped it, but that really is what it is. It's almost like if you're on a treadmill, if you're running, I want people to feel like that is their engine behind them, like the engine that could, you know what I mean?
A different flow.
Absolutely. Keep them going and keep them moving. You know, people get discouraged in life. People, you know, different circumstances come that make you say, you know what, I'm just throwing in the towel. I give up or whatever. But I'm hoping that that song is like an energy to them. It's a strength to them that as they say the lyrics of the song, that they'll start really trying to get to the finish line of their lives.
We're talking live with Jonathan Nelson, and he has a group called Purpose. Now, you moved to Florida.
I did.
And from DMV.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
You know, and DMV ministry is real strong.
Oh, yeah.
What's it like in Florida?
Florida, you know, Florida is laid back. It's more of a multicultural environment. One thing that is different there than here, you know, sometimes you kind of have to like work.
Okay.
Because we have such a musical base here in mm-hmm. the DMV. The level of appreciation for music and for ministry and worship, I have to say it, unfortunately, is stronger there because you have a lot of people from the islands there.
Okay.
And so their appreciation for music, their appreciation for God and so many different things is a little different. So you don't have to necessarily work. It's not churchy. But it is welcoming and warm, right. You know. So that's the worship experience in Florida.
My guest is Jonathan Nelson. Can I give you a secret?
Yes, sir.
My 9-year-old granddaughter gave me every question to ask you.
Really?
Every one of them.
The one I met and took a picture with?
Uh-huh.
Ah, Sweet Pea.
She gave me every question
what's
to
her,
ask you.
What's her name?
Gabrielle.
Gabrielle, this is a shout-out to you, Gabrielle. Thank you for all of the questions.
Jonathan, man, good to see you.
Yes, sir. You too.
I appreciate you, man.
Thank you.
All right. Winston Chaney from The Morning Show and Praise 104.1. Tonight is my man, Jonathan Nelson, and the group Purpose.